So yeah, the response has been absolutely fantastic. I mean, we were really blown away by the level of public support, and we're really grateful for like the amount of people who've shared what it means to them, and also people sharing memories of either coming in and doing things in here, or coming in as a visitor or a participant. So it means a lot to us, and especially to the volunteer team here, to know that what they're doing is really kind of valued and people really care about it. And yeah, it's also made it a public conversation. So we've been working really quietly on this for about 3.5 years with the council and other stakeholders. But now it's a public conversation, and I think it's also really put into the public realm just how important it is to protect, you know, kind of smaller community focused organisations. And also we're an independent art space, and that's a really important thing to remember as well. Yeah, I think it really says something about a city to have an independent art space on the main street, this visible. I think that says a lot about a city. And, you know, it's an art space, but also it's a community space. We're also a festival hub, so we're very flexible and adaptable to what the communities in Limerick need and require. And I think especially now we have this really ambitious plan for commercial and retail and a great vision for Limerick. But it's, you know, it's really important that arts and culture are integrated into that plan and are equally ambitious as well. You know, we serve a lot of different types of communities, artists, you know, which Niamh can talk about in a minute as well. So it's just, we feel it's really important to hold on to that. It's really important. So this has been a really grassroots effort. And I think the fact that people have, you know, been talking about it so publicly, there's a sense that there's a sense of ownership over this space. It's not just about, people feel they want to defend it, they want to be part of it, they feel part of something. So I think that's really special. And yeah, as I said, we're blown away by the response.
I think what's really special about this place is that it can accommodate an awful lot of events and types of events. This year we've hosted, or we're planning to host, or by the end of this year, sorry, we'll have hosted 10 festivals that don't necessarily have a base or a home. So just taking in some of their events, whether it be a workshop or a screening or performance. My background is visual arts, as most of the team, so we've hosted a lot of different and very ambitious visual art projects. Everything from award-winning artists like Richard Moss, who represented Ireland at the Venice Biennale in 2013. So during National City of Culture, we were able to bring that to Limerick, which was really, really important. But also local artists, the current project Museum of Mythological Waterbeasts. There's 5 commissions by Limerick-based artists, which is really important as well. And just to showcase that there is the level of ambition with Limerick artists as well as international artists. And we're not trying to separate Limerick or national or Irish artists from international artists. They all have a home and a place here. And I think that's really, really important. And to show that work to Limerick audiences.
Yeah, I think as well, I mean, I think that's a really brilliant point that, you know, since I've been in Limerick about 10 years, and, you know, since I've been here, people talk about like the local talent and the potential and, you know, there's great skills here, but actually we're really lucky. We get to see that realised on a daily basis, you know, and we get to connect with artists through our Artists in Residence scheme, you know, through the Arts Council Visual Art Project Award, we're commissioning new work by local artists. So we feel really lucky while people are talking about the potentials and the what ifs, we can actually get to do that every day in this space.
Is there much else people can do to help?
Well, I mean, for starters, just getting it into a public discussion and getting feedback and ideas from people. Like, we're always open to that. That's kind of our ethos, actually. So we've had like some great ideas, and we are exploring lots of different avenues. We're working still with the City Council, of course, and with some of our elected members, and looking at what are the best options and like trying to come up with good plans. Really, we want something secure and sustainable for Limerick, basically. So I think getting it, you know, to become higher up in sort of like possibly people's priorities or on the agenda. I mean, we can see now that time is really of the essence. This is an urgent question that we could quite easily lose this space in a very short amount of time. We hope that's not going to be the case, but like, what are the options? So we're working with some, like, people have been really great at and really proactive in kind of contacting and engaging with us and trying to have conversations. Most people, I should say. But really, you know, it's been quite a busy, you know, a couple of weeks, but we're confident and we're pretty determined to keep going. And we know there's a need, and we know there's a desire, you know, to keep going and to be able to house lots of just brilliant projects and great local talent, and yeah, so. But we'll be having a board meeting soon, and a certain number of decisions are going to have to be made at that. So, you know, really the need for a solution is there's a timeline on that. So.